There you go, you're up.
It's a wonderful experience if you're wanting to get into game design. With the addition of the studio, it definitely broadens the amount of people that will that we can offer to the Gaming Institute. Like normally it would just be a lot of programmers and a few artists, but now we can have just as many artists as we can programmers to kind of balance out the type of student that would want to come and be in the Gaming Institute.
You know, around here, within the state, there's nothing like this. In a multi-state region, there's nothing like this. So we're able to offer this as a service, not just to our students, but to the developers outside as well.
With this hardware, it actually records with proprietary software, skeleton based off of human inverse kinematics. What that all means basically is that we can track everything besides fingers, toes, and facial expressions. And so we can actually map the skeleton directly into a model that is a biped model, and it will just plug into our game engine.
I think it would put EKU on the map for students interested in game design because, as you see, it's interactive multimedia, it's hidden. I didn't know this existed until recently, so I was really happy about that. So with this studio, it's like, oh hey, there is something game related going on here, let's check it out.
With this, I now know I don't have to make animations by hand. I can track them from this software and this hardware and actually get my animations to work, and I would have no experience with that otherwise.
Now, EKU is committed to our program, right? We're committed to our students and committed also to the region. And beyond. Nationally, there's not many schools that have this. The best schools do. And you know, that technology, again, shows that we're committed to giving our students the best training possible to be competitive in the field.
I guess you want to try just some walking.